Hello, guys. Yes, I found myself here in Erinsborough Police Station. It's a little bit similar to Cronulla Police Station, I'm going to say. I've been looking for Toadie. Y'all know Toadie. He's one of my favourites. He's not on those wanted posters anymore. A couple of dodgy-looking characters there, but that's where you'd be accustomed to seeing him. Certainly when he joined the show. Since then, he's obviously matured. He's turned his life around, and now he's a lawyer, isn't he? But we're looking for him now because I'm a big fan. I'm a huge fan. But it's... And here he is, Mr. Rebecchi himself.
Sorry, hang on 2 seconds. I lost my
place
now, mate.
I'm
going to have to start
again. That's okay, mate. Do you know what? It's a real pleasure to meet you today. Has it? Oh, well. So who do you play in the show?
I play Jared Toadfish Rebecchi. That guy.
Wait a second. That's you. I thought this was Cyborg. No,
that was the first guy, yeah.
How did that all come about? You've played the roles, haven't you?
Oh, well, yeah, mainly a vandal. Yeah. I'm really good at it, apparently. Let's break some stuff. Yeah.
How awesome is it? It's such an emotional day today. We really appreciate being with you guys. And we're trying to really be sensitive to that, but also celebrate this long show. Yeah, well, that's it, isn't it?
But
how was it for you when you first joined the cast as Toadie Toadfish?
Well, it was pretty cool because I was only meant to be here for one scene. So that scene happened and it was over and done with. And I was like, oh, right, is that it? Everyone's moving on now. Oh, so it was quite kind of deflating.
Well, I mean, we wanted to see a lot more of you. Certainly that striptease that you've done as well. How comfortable was that?
That was nice, actually. Yeah, it's always comfortable. Always love getting my gear off for television. I've done a number of nudie runs on this show, actually.
Right on. Yeah, good for it, all right. And tell us about the mullet. I've been talking about this for so long, and it's something that I wanted. I was hoping we'd get to try it on today, but no one will let me.
Yeah, it's in a cage. Yeah. It's the live rat that's hanging off the back of my head, and I've gone,
Why did it take so long to get rid? Was that something that you wanted to get rid of? Because it's so synonymous, I suppose, with the character Toadie as well.
Yeah. Well, I really wanted to lose my virginity, so it had to go.
Tell us about some of your favourite storylines that came up. I love the wrestling one, to be honest with you.
Yeah, that was pretty cool, actually. I got to actually train with real-life wrestlers, and we went into St Kilda and we, you know, learned the big body slams and all that kind of stuff. So that was pretty cool. But no, but probably my favorite story line was the Sonia's death episode. That was the first time Neighbours has actually done a two-hander episode ever. And that was just so wonderful to be able to shoot that with Eve Morey as well. But probably the most memorable episode was the 6,000th episode, where there was a nudist lunch for Toadie's clients, and Carl lost a raffle ticket. A lottery ticket that was a winner ticket. So he wanted to get it back, and the only way that he could do it was to join the nudist lunch. And the thing that really sticks in my mind is, we'll call them a modesty patch. It's just like a little a little bag that goes over the bits. It leaves nothing to the imagination. And Alan has taken off his wardrobe. He's taken off his... He's just gone, guys, I just want you to just see what it's like before we start. It's like, oh, my God. There it is.
Oh, there you go. Yeah, it's better at sticking in your mind than sticking in your leg, I suppose. So how was it for you then as an actor, I guess? When you started, you're a bit of a rogue and stuff, you know, but then your character matured as the acting matured as well, I suppose, as well. And then you became a lawyer on the show. Enjoy that process.
Look, I've enjoyed every step of the way. Essentially, in the very early days with the House of Trousers stuff, that was really just, you know, three boys just seeing what we could get away with. Yeah. And we would talk the director into doing some of the most stupid things in the world. And he'd go, okay, let's do that. Like having barbecues indoors in the middle of the studio and things like that.
Yeah, well, I mean, you've done it all here as well. Is it true that you're a pilot as well and a beekeeper?
Yeah, I like flying, apparently.
So what's next then for yourself?
I'm going to be dad for a bit. I mean, you know, I'm going to be unemployed for a bit, so if anyone's got a job for me, maybe with you guys, that'd be good, yeah. And I'm really actually looking forward to just being dad for a while. It's going to be nice.
That is really fantastic. You know what? We love you. I'm no bigger fan than myself. We really appreciate you guys having us today. We know it's a very emotional day, but we really appreciate you guys having us here. You've been entertaining us for years, and you continue to do so now.
You know what? Thank you. Thank you guys for actually coming here and doing this, because it's actually making us feel quite special. There's a whole heap of nostalgia that's happening with everybody that's working here at the moment, and it's things like this that actually kind of almost reflect how important what we have done really is to the Australian landscape. So thank you for showing us your love as well.
Of course. And not just Australia, in Ireland too. I'm going to be uncomfortable. I'm going to get a cuddle now if you don't mind. Here you go.
Of course.
There we go. Now, it really has been great for us today. There's plenty more emotions coming your way, but certainly plenty more celebrations as well. We'll be right back with more from the set of Neighbours after this.